Folks, so I get this question a lot. It's about supplements. What supplements you should take? Do you need supplements? My opinion on supplements. All right. So the first rule when it comes to supplements, right? If you're inconsistent, if you're not serious, if you're not taking your health serious, if you're not in the gym consistently, yeah, don't take supplements, right? Don't waste your money, because you should only spend money on these items when you're serious, like deadly serious about your fitness goal. So that's rule number one. Don't even think about supplements, right? Rule number two, just I'm gonna give you the hierarchy of what I think is most important. And this is just not what I think, this is just fact, right? The first thing, the most important thing is nutrition, right? Without nutrition, it doesn't matter, right? Like if your diet sucks, and you work out 7 days a week, it doesn't matter, you're not gonna look good. And you're gonna get all types of diseases, high cholesterol. If you're eating junk, your health, you'll die, right? There's a lot of diseases associated with poor diet. So that's the most important thing on the hierarchy of health and fitness. Number two, the second most important thing is sleep, right? You gotta sleep for a number of reasons. I'm not gonna get into that. Third most important thing on the hierarchy of health and fitness is exercise, is moving your body, right? And then fourth is supplements at the bottom, right? At the bottom. So I'm just painting a picture for you of how important vitamins are, how important supplements are. They're at the bottom of the hierarchy when it comes to health and fitness. So that's one thing to keep in mind. All right, now let's get into the nitty gritty. These are things that I think, these are supplements that I feel will move the needle for you, right? So, and then I'll get into vitamins and minerals and all that other stuff. But the first thing that, a really effective supplement is creatine. Now, creatine they've done hundreds of tests, maybe even thousands of scientific studies on creatine. It's the most studied supplement out there, right? It works. So basically what creatine is, it'll help you build muscle. You'll look bigger, and it does it through water. The downfall about creatine, and why I don't take creatine, is that when you stop taking creatine, it goes away, because it's water weight basically you pick up. It's water and you just look bigger, you look good. But in my mind, I never really used it because I didn't see the sense in using something. Like, what's the purpose in my mind of building muscle, right? Using this supplement, and the moment I stop using it, I'm gonna just taper off. And I just rather work out, you know what I mean? So get creatine monohydrate, all right? Don't get any other form of creatine. They'll try to sell you another one, and that hasn't been tested like creatine monohydrate. Just get creatine monohydrate. All right, that's probably gonna be mostly for the fellas. You guys are probably gonna really mess with that creatine. Unless you're a female and you're looking to put on a lot of muscle, you'll probably get some creatine, but most females won't mess with creatine. The second most effective supplement is caffeine, right? Caffeine, man, is extremely powerful, man. You wanna be careful with it, though. That's the caveat. Caffeine is addictive. It'll boost your adrenals, right? So if you drink too much caffeine, your body won't respond to it anymore. It won't be as effective, and eventually, you'll just have to take higher and higher dosages of caffeine. You wanna be very careful with it, but caffeine is powerful, man, to the point where it pops on drug tests. Like, they test for it in certain sports if your caffeine levels are too high. So before a athletic competition, if you gas up on a whole bunch of caffeine, and I didn't, and you're all pumped shifting into another gear that I'm not shifting into. I know people who, they'll get to the gym. I've seen this happen numerous times. They'll get to the gym and they'll forget their pre-workout. They'll go back home and get the pre-workout before they work out. I'm telling you, like a whole 20-minute trip there and back before they go there. I don't take pre-workout just because, I mean, I just don't take it. I never saw the need to take it. I've tried it before, but I don't need it to work out, so I don't wanna start, it's just something else to buy. I don't need it to work out. It doesn't make sense for me to just start randomly taking pre-workout, but it works. You wanna get a good one, all right? So caveat here, folks, whenever you're buying supplements, if it ever says proprietary blend, you wanna avoid it, don't use it, all right? You want all the products, all the ingredients in the dosages listed on the back. And if somebody, most companies, they'll put proprietary blend because they will skimp out on the main ingredients of the supplement, and they'll just fill it with like rice filler. So they'll put like a dash of the really important stuff, and the rest of the stuff will be like rice filler, wheat, some random product that has no benefit to you whatsoever. So you wanna avoid proprietary blends because that protects the company, allows them to just put whatever in there, not list the dosages. So you wanna make sure you don't buy a proprietary blend. Now we're getting into vitamins, man. If there's anything that I think you need, it's a multivitamin, man. You need a multivitamin, especially in 2019. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys aren't getting all your vitamins and nutrients from your food. So you gotta supplement that. So I take a multivitamin. I'll put it in the description, man. I'm not big on pitching companies too tough, but this multivitamin in particular is really good, man. So I'll put a link in the description below for that. I think you got the benefit, but you need to get your vitamins and nutrients in, man. Very important that that happens. Next is protein. If you're not getting your protein from your food, folks, you want to make sure you supplement protein, get a good protein. I like to use a vegan-based protein. It's good, man. If you can't, I suggest you get your stuff from food. All right, but if you can't get it, if you're busy, you want to get some protein powder that way, because protein is extremely important, man. It's one of the macronutrients, right? And it's also essential for building muscle. You need it to build muscle. So you want to make sure you get your protein in, and you could do that through food or you could supplement it. I'm a busy guy. I'm always running around. So for me, I usually need 2 scoops of protein. But, you know, when I'm on my game and I'm meal prepping and I have a little bit more time, I'll just get it from the food. I'd rather get it from the food than a supplement. All right? So anyway, folks, hopefully that was helpful. If it was, click that subscribe button. Mank.